First of all, we're gonna start with the contrast putting into the searing. It's 20 cc. The first method of infusing the contrast media is with the histrophore. It's the oldest method of infusion of the contrast media. You can use three different tips at the histrophore, and you put it on. This one, you put on the cervix, then you attach the histrophore to stabilize it on the cervix. Then you can start with infusion of the contrast media into the uterus. A second method of infusing the contrast media into the uterus is the balloon catheter. This catheter you put into the cervix or the lower part of the uterus. To fixate the catheter, you will inflate the balloon at the tip of the catheter so it will stay inside. You will disconnect this one, and then through the other port you can inflate the contrast media into the uterus. Then the last way to insert the contrast media into the uterus is the cervical vacuum cup. This cervical vacuum cup you attach at the cervix with this part into the cervical channel. Then you put the vacuum through this one on the cervix so it will stay attached at the cervix. And then you can infuse the contrast media through this channel. Then I will get out all the air of the syringe. I will insert the speculum to visualize the cervix. I will clean the cervix a little bit before I will attach the vacuum cup on the cervix. Now I will flush the vacuum cup before I will attach it. First, we will start with a plain picture, so we can compare the other pictures with the first plain one. Now I will start with slow infusion of the contrast media. Very slow, because then it will be less painful for the patient. Over here you see the filling of the uterus, and you can see filling of both tubes. Now we make a couple of pictures during infusion to check if we will see the oil drops coming out of both tubes. Okay, perfect. Now we finished the infusion of the contrast media. Both tubes are open. Over here you can see the bone structures, and over here you can see the catheter, the tip of the catheter, the vacuum cup filled with contrast medium. This is the next picture. Over here you see the filling of the uterus. Over here, filling of left fallopian tube. First part of the tube is very thin, that's normal. And this is the filling of the last part, the last end of the fallopian tubes. It's a little bit wider, that's normal, that's because of the mucal folds. This is the right tube of the patient. It's also filled with contrast medium till the end of the fallopian tube. Over here you already can see some contrast medium coming out of the left fallopian tube, and it will stream into the abdominal cavity. So at this picture we can see that the left tube is open. And at this picture, you can see that both tubes are open. Also at the right side, you can see that the contrast medium is coming into the abdominal cavity. And on the left side, it's even more. And over here, it's a short film. You can see the typical oil drops coming into the abdominal cavity from the right tube. And also from the left tube, you can see streaming of the oil contrast into the abdominal cavity. So that means that both fallopian tubes are patent, and this is an example of a normal HSG. Now we will show you a couple of HSG pictures with abnormality findings.